Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. On the SGI graph, we see from the previous time frame, we see very obvious clustering. It's a perfect example of temporal clustering of strong earthquakes, typically the mid to high 5 magnitude earthquakes. We actually have three distinct temporal clusters on the 16th, which is related to the geometry that occurred before that cluster. Then on the 19th, remember I said that because of a convergence on the 17th, we could see stronger seismic activity, possibly clustering on the 18th, 19th. And indeed, on the 19th, we have an obvious cluster of stronger earthquakes, but it stayed in the magnitude 5 range. Then we have this strong convergence on the 21st and 22nd, primarily semi-right angle planetary and lunar geometry. And I marked the 22nd and 23rd as potential days for increased seismic activity, the typical clustering of stronger earthquakes. And indeed, it was a very strong strong clustering with two magnitude 6 earthquakes, a 6.2 in Indonesia on the 22nd and a 6.2 in Western Turkey, which was in the center of the Marmara Sea. Remember, stronger earthquakes tend to occur in clusters. These are the typical temporal clusters, not to confuse with spatial clusters. Spatial clusters is a clustering and swarming of earthquakes in a single area. But temporal clustering without the spatial component, that is the typical clustering of stronger earthquakes in various locations across the planet. And that's what we emphasize on our SGI graphs every time, because it happens most of the time. Remember, stronger earthquakes tend to occur in temporal clusters. We have a high lunar peak today, and that's what we're going to discuss next. If you look at the next time frame, up until the 4th of May, we see primarily lunar geometry, but there is some convergence of planetary geometry as well, and that happens today with Earth, Venus, Saturn, and Venus, Sun, Uranus. Earth, Venus, Saturn happens at the same time that we see this high lunar peak, and that is, if you look at the solar system, because of Earth, Venus, and Saturn in a conjunction, the Moon is in between. That means that we have effectively a quadruple conjunction, Earth, Moon, Venus, and Saturn. That can result in stronger seismic activity. I'll come to that in a minute. We also have Venus, Sun, and Uranus in a conjunction. Also, that's later today, and that is a more critical factor to this geometry overall. There is an absence of Mercury. Mercury is not in there. That is a positive sign. But Venus, Sun, and Uranus, that is a critical factor. So let's have a look at the SGI graph again. We see a convergence here on the 25th. And three lunar conjunctions, that's with Saturn, Venus, and Neptune, while Earth, Venus, and Saturn are in a conjunction, and that's followed by Venus, Sun, Uranus, we could see a seismic response, the typical clustering on the 26th, 27th. There could be a larger earthquake in there, I think around the 27th. Is it going to reach magnitude 7? Maybe, because of Venus, Sun, and Uranus in there. I say maybe. There's a small chance that that's going to happen probably later on the 26th or 27th. Because it is still quite a convergence of planetary lunar geometry that we have here on the 25th. But overall, I expect this typical clustering, higher 5 magnitude earthquakes mostly. On the 27th, we have a new moon and we have a high lunar peak. That's because of semi-right angle geometry of both Jupiter and Saturn. That is basically sort of an overlap with the lunar and planetary convergence on the 25th. So I say the 27th, there could be some stronger seismic activity. If we take into account this convergence of lunar geometry on the 27th, we could see a seismic response to that geometry on the 29th. And that's when the Moon will be in a conjunction with Uranus. There could be some stronger seismic activity in there. The typical higher 5 again, clustering perhaps on the 29th, 28th, 29th. I think the 29th is critical there. There could be a magnitude 6 in there as well. Because of the convergence of lunar geometry, mid to high 6 potentially around the 29th, we have Earth, Moon, Jupiter in a conjunction coming up. These lunar conjunctions that typically result in this stronger seismic activity in the higher 5 magnitude range. And if there is enough stress in Earth's crust, also magnitude 6. And then we have Earth, Venus, and Neptune on the 2nd of May, and that will be followed by, again, a convergence of lunar geometry on the 4th, And we see Earth, Moon, Mars in a conjunction. And we see again Jupiter and Saturn with semi-right angle geometry, 45 and 135 degrees. And that could result in some clustering of stronger earthquakes on the 5th, 6th of May. So for now, I'd say around the 27th, we could see stronger seismic activity, the critical seismic activity potentially reaching 6 magnitude. In the worst case scenario, magnitude 7. I think that's the most critical time here. And also the 29th. Check out the updates, the latest updates on the website and social media. Also the atmospheric anomalies. It's very difficult to pinpoint exact locations. We do estimates. We are not there yet. We cannot say there's going to be an earthquake in this location or that location. We have temporal clustering. We know pretty well on what days there is a higher probability of stronger earthquakes, but you're determining exact locations, that is a difficult thing. We are not really there yet. The atmospheric anomalies, they are an indicator. It's in infancy, but it isn't perfect. And that's something that we have to accept at this point. Okay, so check out the latest updates. Stay safe. Until next time.